Jesse Laflamme, and I'm co-owner of Pete and Gerry's Organic Eggs with my father, Gerry.
Our farm here in Monroe is about 176 acres, and in various buildings we have a total of about 150,000 egg-laying hens, and each one of those hens lays about 300 eggs a year. And we also work with about over 20 family farms throughout the Northeast, and they usually have between 10 and 19,000 hens on each farm. And all the eggs are processed here in Monroe. One of the main reasons that we put the system in is that it's incredibly frustrating to have outside winter temperatures and to go inside your cooler and know that your compressors and refrigeration system are taking energy and trying to cool that space down, when the outside is cooler than the 45 degrees that we're trying to achieve. So the free air system actually shuts the compressors off entirely and pulls in cool, filtered air from the outside to carry the load of cooling. In our egg processing, food safety and quality is a major issue. It's very important for us. And we developed a system called Passive Track, where cooler temperatures, among other points, wash water temp and chlorine levels, sanitizer levels, are monitored on an ongoing basis. But we were able to use that system because it is monitoring the temperature in our two coolers, four points, to see that the free air system is working exactly the way it's supposed to, and we're keeping our eggs at the correct temperature. And we can see the efficiency because it's letting the cooler temperature rise slightly and then fall back down in a more efficient way than keeping the temperature level. FDA and USDA require that the eggs are kept at 45 degrees or less in our coolers, and in the past, before the free air system, during the hottest times of the summer, we seem to always be fighting a refrigeration unit that would ice up because the defrost cycles just weren't correct or weren't reliable, and we'd have to stop production. The free air system exercises defrost cycles in a much more precise way, and we've eliminated the problem with those air handling units icing up. So it's keeping our product where it's supposed to be. It's keeping the product in better temperatures, higher quality. The other great benefit in terms of energy saving that we're seeing is that refrigeration systems are really kind of dumb. They're very, very simple systems. They're looking for a certain temperature in the cooler, and they just keep running and running and running until they reach that. But the truth is, the air handling systems, the condensers in the cooler, may be as cold as they're going to get. You're just wasting energy by running those compressors. So the free air system shuts down your compressors and is monitoring the temperature of the air handlers and waits for them to rise in temperature. So you're not running your compressors as much, and you're not losing anything. You're saving energy and accomplishing the same amount of cooling. So one of our biggest goals here is to reduce our carbon footprint, and when we first put the system in, we estimated that we would save about 70,000 pounds of carbon a year, output a year, and it ended up being over 80,000 pounds. Our estimated energy savings for the year is 26%, and it turned out that we saved 48%.
So we can see in the display for the last 365 days that the compressor has only run for 23% of the time in this entire space. Not bad.